This film is to contrast the 1967's Bonnie and Clyde portrayed by Warren Beatty and Faye Dunaway to the real story. Bonnie Parker, born October 1, 1910 in Rowanna, Texas, moved to the slums of Dallas with her family at a young age where she worked as a waitress. At 16, she married Rob Thornton, an abusive husband already involved in theft and other charges. After his jailing, Bonnie left and never saw him again due to her death. She grew up during the Great Depression and the Dust Bowl, which was especially hard for the South. Clyde Barrow brought the excitement that she needed in her life.
Clyde Barrow.
Hi, I'm Bonnie Parker. Pleased to meet you.
Clyde Barrow, born March 4th, 1909, was also poor. Majorly influenced by his bigger brother, Marvin, also known as Buck, he started stealing cars and robbing at an early age. After going to prison once again, he tried to clean up and work at a glass factory. He wanted to be a hard worker, but harassment by police and local enforcement led him back to a crime spree, where he started with Bonnie. Bonnie and Clyde, compared to most fact versus fiction films, accurately portrays the personality and backgrounds of the characters. Buck, Clyde's brother, led him to robbery and eventually murder. He was a very bad influence from the start of his life. Their crime spree from 1932 to 1934 led them to high publicity, where their name was headlined in papers all around, many attached with wanted papers and high rewards, dead or alive. Gas stations and grocery stores were their main targets. It wasn't as much big businesses and banks that we see today. Buck and his wife Blanche joined the spree. They wanted more money for themselves and were hoping to find that with Clyde. They were early members of what we call the Barrow Gang. Although during a shootout, 1933, at Dexfield Park, Buck was killed by gun wounds to his back. His wife Blanche was captured mourning over his body, and she served jail time for 6 years. She was released on parole, and she lived out the rest of her life until 1988 when she passed away. In reality, Bonnie and Clyde met through a mutual friend, whereas the movie portrays them meeting by him trying to hijack her mother's car. Their relationship was on a hiatus when Clyde was arrested. In reality, Clyde hated jail more than portrayed because he was sexually assaulted multiple times. Bonnie brought a gun into the jail and helped break Clyde out of it, where they started their spree. In the movie, Clyde is portrayed as trying to help someone who has been harmed by both the Dust Bowl and the Great Depression. In reality, the money that he stole was not for those who were harmed by the Great Depression, but solely for himself and the needs of his own. The Joplin, Montana shootout of 1933 was not shown correctly. At a rented apartment, police scare off the Barrow gang with their many bullets into the house. Though none of the gang is harmed, some of the police officers are, and the remnants includes a camera roll where we see many famous photos of today. Bonnie was devastated when during an accident, battery acid spilled all over her leg. She shortly after had to be carried most of the time and made running away more difficult than it already was. C.W. Moss is one character that represents part of the full Barrow gang. He mainly represents Henry Mevithan, who was a friend of Clyde's in jail. Clyde later helped him escape to join the Barrow gang. The importance of Henry and his father Yvonne was not shown throughout the whole movie. Yvonne let the whole Barrow gang hang out in his Louisiana cabin for safety, but once the police discovered this, they harassed Yvonne into setting a trap for both Bonnie and Clyde. Although, for his cooperation, his son would not be involved in it, and his son would receive full amnesty from the police office. Yvonne's love for her son led to the ultimate demise of Bonnie and Clyde in 1934. Six men rained 167 bullets over the couple, killing them. Many tried to souvenir their deaths with pieces of hair and body parts that they tried to capture. Many also attended their funeral to see who exactly was Bonnie and Clyde and the mystery behind of them. They were not buried in the same cemetery and are currently live out today as an over-romanticized couple.